this again. I'm a pharmacist, but 7 years ago I decided to shift my career. So I being an English teacher. I taught English in Saudi Arabia for 2 years, and I've been teaching English in Ireland for probably 5 years now. And a year ago, or maybe a year and a half, I decided to start my online, YouTube channel, because I learned a lot since I came here to Ireland. So I decided to share my experience with others. So as you see here on the screen, this is the name of my YouTube channel. So we meet weekly in this class. If you missed any of the previous classes, you can find them online on my YouTube channel. We meet every week, every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Ireland, 9 p.m. Egypt, and 10 p.m. KSA time. And that's me. So, feel free to take a look at my channel. And I'd like to apologize for not being with you last class, and I hope you miss me as much as I do miss you, because I really miss this class a lot. As you said, today we're going to talk about money and banking, and we'll start straight away. I'll just first start going through the group agreement. So first of all, we need to accept and respect each other. We'll have one voice at a time. I'm gonna allow you to unmute yourself. Okay, so I don't have to do it myself. Like if you want to speak, just unmute yourself. That's okay. The thing is, we need to have one voice at a time. So if someone is speaking, please wait until he or she finishes, and then you can feel free to speak after that. So we speak only in English because this is an English speaking class. And if you feel shy to speak, don't. Okay, try as much as you can to speak, because again, this is an English speaking class, and you have a maximum of 3 minutes to speak. This is just, to give everyone the chance to speak. And I always say, and I like to say, and like to repeat that every time we meet here, this is a judgment-free zone. So no one here is going to judge you. No one here is going to say that you have a bad English or you are not, pronouncing this word right. No, okay, not in this class at least. So it's a judgment-free zone. And I always say this is all about progress, not perfection, okay? So we all make mistakes, and this is the only way we can learn, okay? You don't have to be perfect all the time. But being here in this class and, trying to speak in English, that's, the very first step of improving yourself. So these are basically the group agreement or the group rules. So if you agree to that, please type yes in the chat box and we'll start this straight away. So Saeed from Asyut, welcome Saeed. The channel is this name. It's Easy English with Nancy. You will find it easily. Farah said, I just wanted some advice about reading in general. Okay, Farah, can I, will leave maybe 5 minutes at the end for questions and answers, if that's okay. So we will have a chance to start our topic today, and then I'll leave, I promise, 5 minutes at the end. So we have Farah from Egypt. We have Doha from Tunisia, Saeed from Asyut, Shireen from Egypt. So we're all Arabs today. Are we? Okay. Good. So we'll start, and you all can see the screen, right? Yes. Great. Hanan, I'm glad that you're here. So you can hear me well. Feel free to unmute yourself.
Hi, Nancy. How are you?
I finally, you every time. You
finally, yes. I was fighting just to join you every time there is a problem, but alhamdulillah, thank God that I'm here. I've heard you that introducing the others. One is from Asyut.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm living in Asyut as well also.
Now?
Yes. No, not now. No.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
This is the my home.
Okay, your hometown from Asyut.
I'm Saidi.
That's good. So you have someone who's from your city as well, so who is Saeed, which is great. But I'm glad that you're here with us, Hanan, and you don't have any problem with connection, hopefully. You still can hear me? Yeah. Okay, so we will start. I'll just let you watch something first. It's just 1 minute, and then we will discuss it. It's a part from a movie. So just let me know if you can. Can you see it on the screen? Yeah, just type yes in the chat box. Can you guys see the movie on the screen? Yeah, great. I will play it. And if you want me to increase the volume or something, tell me, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen.
This is an actual robbery. Kiss the ground. Don't breathe. Don't move. Don't touch the sign of the alarm unless you like bullets flying around your head. Hit the dirt, big guy. Put that gun away. Okay, folks, we'll be out of your lives in 2 minutes. Get moving, Blue Eyes. Here we go.
I'll tell us, please stand up and open your windows.
No dye packs, no tracers.
All you got, Missy, no tracers, no dye packs, no body.
Yes, Mr. Sinatra.
Nobody's gonna get hurt.
20 seconds.
Okay. So, who can tell me what is going on? Or what's happening? Guys, just before you speak, well, you can unmute yourself, but just raise your hand so you don't have like too many people unmuting themselves at the same time, okay? So who can tell me what was happening? Come on, it's a speaking class. So anybody? Farah, okay, Farah. You tell us, not in the chat box. Tell us, Farah.
I heard that somebody was robbing a bank.
Yeah.
They were trying to rob a bank.
Yes. Okay. So we call this action a bank. A bank what?
Robbery.
Yes. Excellent. So a bank robbery, and they were trying to rob the bank. So what we call those criminals?
Robbers.
The robbers. Know. Yes. Yeah. Excellent. Very good. So the verb is rob. The like the action is bank robbery, and the people or the person who does that, we call him robber. Thank you so much, Farah. Yeah. And have you seen this movie?
Actually, no.
You didn't. Okay. I'll ask someone else to guess the name of the movie, but it's very funny. By the way, so when they tell us the name, you can watch it later if you have time. Okay. Thanks, Farah. Okay, Shireen.
Yes.
Hi, how are you?
I'm Shireen. I am from Egypt, from Alex, my home from in Alex. They're trying to break into the bank.
Yes. Okay. And have you seen this movie? Do you know what is the name of the movie?
No, okay. I don't know. It's my first time to watch it.
Okay, it's very fun, by the way. It's no accent.
I want to clear something for you. I want to tell you something. The voice wasn't clear.
Ah, okay. How about now?
Not you.
The movie. Okay.
Yes.
It's okay. It's actually not to hear as it's more like watching and tell me about the action itself. Yeah. Okay. Because I know sometimes it's not that much clear. Okay, so do you think anyone would guess? Anybody has seen this movie before? Anyone can guess?
No.
You don't think so, Shireen? Okay, the name?
I know the movie, Indian movie, like that English movie, but I couldn't remember the name of that movie. Okay. I remember the action.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, the name of the movie is Going in Style. Going in Style. Okay, I write it down for you in case. And it's actually action comedy. It's very funny. I'll write it in the chat box. Going in Style. Do you know Morgan Freeman?
Going in Style.
Yeah. Okay. So thank you, Shireen. Or maybe if you would like, let me give you a chance to answer the first question. So do you like movies about big money bank robbery?
Do you like a movie? You ask me, do you like a movie?
About bank robbery?
Yes. It's so exciting.
Okay.
They have an idea how to break into the bank without catching.
Yeah, without being caught.
It's amazing.
Me too. I really like it. Yeah, and it's like you feel like, oh well, they are so smart.
How they can do that without the police come and catch them?
Yes.
How they can do that? I know it's wrong, but the way they stole something, yeah, it's so exciting.
Yes, yeah, you're absolutely right. I really like these kind of movies. And I'm like, oh, please, I hope the police won't catch them at the end of the movie, you know? I'm like taking the side of the bad guys.
But they didn't catch him.
Yeah. You're right.
And they earn a lot of money and live their life by the way.
Yes.
It's to make me happy. And
yeah,
I know.
Me too.
I know it's...
Yeah, it's wrong, but you're like, you know, we're so engaged to the action or what's happening that we really are that guy's side.
Yeah. The brilliant, right.
Yeah, thank you, Shireen. Let's take.
Thank you.
Okay, Tasu, hello.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you well. Hello, Tasu. Am I pronouncing your name right?
Yeah, it's going perfectly all right.
Yeah, Tasub, right? Tasub.
Yeah, it's Tasub.
Yeah, hello, Tasub. Where are you from?
I'm from Bangladesh. It's 1 p.m. In that time in our country, but I was seeing your program for the last 2 weeks. I think your program is good, so
So it's 1 a.m. at your country. Where are you from? Sorry?
I'm from Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Okay. It's 1 a.m. there. So I really appreciate that you're staying up late, you know, to be with us today. Thank you so much.
Okay. What are you talking today? Are we talking about selling money from banks, something like that?
Yeah, we're talking about money and banks in general. And is it your first time to attend the class with us?
Yeah, this is the first class.
So we basically meet every Wednesday and we pick a topic to talk about every week. So today's topic is about money and banks. So I wrote a few questions here in the presentation about banks. And I just put the question on the screen and I allow people to talk about their own experience. So this is a question for you. What are the different reasons people go to the bank?
Okay, thank you for asking me the question.
Yeah, you're welcome.
What are different reasons people go to the bank? About banking system, for last 2 or 3 years, I have a different opinion. Can I share that?
Yeah, of course. Go ahead. Okay. But sorry, before you start, Tasub, you have like a maximum of 3 minutes just to allow others to tell us their opinions as well. Okay, so go ahead.
Okay, it sounds good. Okay, for last 2 or 3 years, I was trying to understand why in our country, to be honest, bank robbery is getting too much and a large amount of money being transferred to the foreign countries. Those who are powerful, they are taking those monies to the outside countries and they try to build industries. That's one kind of what should I say, big corruption. So I support Bitcoin. Do you know anything about Bitcoin?
About what?
Bitcoin.
Bitcoin, yeah. I heard about it, but I'm still like, you know, I don't use it.
Okay, Bitcoin is a currency who connect peep to peep. It's a digital currency, so it don't require any bank. So this is of corruption where the bank are giving illegal money to someone who are powerful, that will be stopped. So I think instead of bank, in future we'll see inshallah use of Bitcoins and other digital currencies. So the who earn money after a very what should I say, after a very hard working manner, or work hard for their money, they okay. should get more safety, more security. So I think that's why Bitcoin should be the next currency. They let come
Tasub, do you use Bitcoin yourself? Do you use it?
Okay, yeah, to be honest, in our country Bitcoin is illegal or forbidden, but I okay. used for some purposes with some of my friends in America, because America they use Bitcoin quite often, and I use it, to be honest, and the security level is quite high, the cost, if you are transacting money through banks, there are some costs, but in Bitcoin, that sort of cost is negligible. So okay. Bitcoin, if you exchange Bitcoin or using Bitcoin, then you will feel the difference between the banks and the Bitcoin system.
Okay.
Let's come to the point. What are the different reasons people are going to the bank? There are really different reasons. Someone going for their loans, like house loan, car loan, and other loans.
Yeah.
And the general people like me went to bank to get money every month. Those who are government job holder, they get money from the bank every single month. And there are other reasons too. Those who want to deposit some money for their future, they went to bank every for their needs. I think bank is a right now, still now, bank is a necessary part and parcel for our social life.
Yeah.
And I think next generation will. Whatever they choose, they will try to maintain a good relationship with the financial sector. The bank is a financial, financial institution. So this sort of institution will be required. Whatever the next generation want to, invest or wherever they want to put their money, bank will be there. So there are some reasons, but I think
you actually said them all. I think you haven't left anything for anybody to say, which is very good, excellent. Tasub, you have like a lot of a lot of things to say about that, which is very good. And you know what, I'll get back to you maybe if we have some time to talk a little more, because I have a few questions about the Bitcoin. It has been always in my mind, but since I have nobody who has experience about that, so no answer for my question. I tried to read about it online, but I never understood anything.
I'll be happy to share my info.
Thank you. We will give you a chance to speak again. Thank you so much, Tasub.
Okay, sure.
Hey, thanks. Okay, so Tasub said actually a lot of things, a lot of reasons why people go to the bank. He said they go for loan, just the basic things, or normal people like us maybe go for just to open a bank account or something. Well, before I move to the other slide, anybody would like to say or to add anything? Farah, we have Farah, Hanan, Nagla, we have Saeed. Saeed is Okay, Saeed said he's gonna leave because he's not in good health. So get well soon, Saeed, and hopefully you will be okay. And then we have Shireen and Tasuk just spoke now. So anybody would like to say anything? So we have Shireen. Yeah.
I don't have nothing. But I'm studying. What the artist going to study? I'm studying Faculty of Commerce. Hello, you hear
that's,
me?
That's very good. Yes, yes, I hear you. So you are studying in Faculty of Commerce. I was hoping that I get someone who is in the Faculty of Commerce to explain to us what
it's
you know.
It's so exciting. you have to use your mind all the time.
Is it? Okay, I know. Yeah.
Yes.
Do you know, Shireen, I think people who are in a Faculty of Commerce or business, they are very smart, because I tried myself to join a business class and I dropped off the class after 2 weeks. I couldn't bear it.
Yeah. It's so exhausting. It's more, it's there are many level in commerce. You need to be focused in each detail.
Yeah, you
can't make any mistake.
Yeah,
can't make any mistake. But I find the happiness really when I related with number.
All right, okay. So that's the best place for you.
But finding a job in that career in nowadays is so hard. Yeah. You can't find it easy. Yeah. So you have to take many courses and I find something. If you want to achieve your target in accounting field, your language should be more than perfect.
Okay. Yeah. So that's
English.
We are
your
here.
English should we be more than perfect. Yes. I'm trying. I'm calling you to overcome my fearing in talking English.
Now you are very good, and you don't sound scared or something. You know, like your voice doesn't shiver or
I'm
anything.
I'm trying to use English all my day. I follow you on Instagram. I'm trying to comment every.
Oh, really? Oh, that's so nice of you. Thank you, Shireen.
Yes. You are so cute, really. Okay.
Thank you.
And you make me motivate to learn more. And really, it's my favorite language, English. I want to learn more than language, really.
That's perfect. That's very good. So tell me, Shireen, what are the different reasons people go to the bank?
Different reason before what? Couldn't get your question.
Okay, so what are the different reasons people go to the bank? Why do people go to the bank? You have the question on screen.
For many reasons.
Yeah, tell me.
For many reasons. Two type of people. Some people want to save their money and get a profit to live in a stable level. Some other want to invest their money and make a big project and be a businessman. Some of them wanted to take a loan to invest in, but it's so hard to take loan and start a new project because it's require many things, and it should depend in.
هي
بتعتمد على مبالغ معينه with the idea of project if they confess or no it make many steps
and I think a lot of paperwork many steps.
If they they face that problem but in Egypt nowadays they provide that easy that what I can say I want to say يعني عايزه اقول ان وزاره التضامن الاجتماعي I don't want to waste your time because it will take time to make the word.
It's okay for me, honestly. I can even, you know, go more than 1 hour, but I want you to try because, you know, the easiest
thing. They try to provide the project for the young users, but that's the good, yeah, yes, the good idea for young users to
user.
Okay. To improve the there's yes, but it depends to take a loan. I think that is the problem. If the project success or not, they think more in that point. I think in that point.
So you think that you want to say
that project?
You think that to accept any project they need to have like low risks? Is that what you want to say?
No, I don't, and I'm not thinking in that way. I don't. I don't depend on anyone or any ministry to start my project. I want to depend on myself. Because I know what I have, what I can, what I don't have. No more responsibility. No more thinking in how I will success or no. Depending on yourself.
But sometimes you want someone to support you because you don't, for example, have enough money if you want to start big.
Support me by words but not money.
Okay,
because I know when I didn't find the job I couldn't stay without a job. Really
good.
I think to start to make something I couldn't imagine that I can do handmade bag. So I bring the material and start to make it. I don't know that I can do the bag, but I didn't.
Yes, you never know until you are in the situation, Shireen, and which is good. You are a hard worker, so that's perfect. It's good that you are even thinking this way.
The free time, I don't like to spend my time without doing nothing. Because thinking more, I don't love to think, but I love to do, to work, to something to make me live better. Not for money, but for
living.
For your happiness.
Yeah, that's perfect.
For your day, for you finding something making you happy.
Yeah, thank you so much, Shireen. You motivated me.
Thank you
very much, Shireen, for your participation. So let's jump to the next slide. So Shireen said a lot about the different reasons why people go to the bank. So I just tried to sum them up here in this slide. So can we have maybe someone who would read this? These are the different reasons why people go to the bank. So we have here Sahar, Tasoob, Shireen just spoke, Nagla, Hanan, Farah, and Buda Hain. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing this wrong. So anybody would like to just unmute yourself and read the slides, okay? So these are the different reasons why people go to the bank. Hello, Nagla.
Okay, hi, how are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Fine, alhamdulillah.
Okay.
Open an account or close an account.
Yeah.
Get, I don't know how to pronounce it, but we can say it like debit card. Debit card or credit card.
Yeah.
Transfer money, set up online banking, open joint account, withdraw cash or make a deposit.
Yeah, yes. So these are some of the reasons why people go to the bank. So tell me, Nagla, do you know the meaning of them all or is there any new word for you?
No, I don't know. What does it mean? Withdraw cash. I don't know. What does it mean?
Okay.
And I don't know. Deposit. I think deposit is something like I take some cash and I can give it them back after a while, or with certain like intervals, something like that.
Not really, but it's actually the ATM.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Okay, so you have your card, and then you insert your card. And then when you go to the ATM, and you want to have some money. So you put the card and then you write the amount that you want, let's say $100 or something. So you write $100 and then the machine gives you $100. So the action that you have just done now is withdrawing cash, okay? You withdraw cash, okay? So you took money from the machine. And the opposite of that, if you want to put the money to the machine, is actually called make a deposit, okay? So it's now you can do that through the ATM instead of going to the bank and standing in the queue and all that. So if you have money and then you want to put that money in your bank account, so you can do it through the ATM. So I have $100 now. I put them in the machine, and that's this action is called making a deposit.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
So do you know it in Arabic?
Idea idea صح كده مظبوط
idea yeah.
وصاحب صاحبه yeah. idea صح
ولا excellent excellent yeah, well done. So you got it
yes okay thank you Nagla
welcome. Okay guys, before we jump to the next slide, I want to ask you, do you know the meaning of joint account? Joint account, anybody? Anyone?
Joint account, right?
Yes.
And joint account is something you can open with someone, you know. If I want to open an account on behalf of my family,
yes.
Suppose I and my brother want to open a bank account, both of us can deposit in the same account.
Yes.
And that will be a joint account.
Yeah. Excellent, Tasu. Very good. Well done. Thank you so much for your participation. So it's exactly as Tasub said, joint account is the account that you share with someone else. So I can share an account with my husband, with my maybe a work partner or something. So both of us can access the account. We both can withdraw cash or make a deposit. We both can, you know, control the this account. So it's called joint account. Okay. Good. I'll tell you a word. So you see all these things that you can actually do in the bank. You can use this. I always call this a magic word because this word is very polite and you can use it in every situation when you are out of words in English. So you'd say, I'd like to. Okay, so you can use this. I'd like to. And then let's go back to this slide. I'd like to open an account, or I'd like to close an account, or I'd like to have a debit card or a credit card, or I'd like to transfer money. So it's basically I want to, but it's like more polite and it's more formal, you know, or good English, as we say. Good. Let's go to the next question. So do you have a bank account? If so, why? Why do you have a bank account? We have here, Budahi, you haven't shared anything with us today. So would you like to speak? Hello? Okay. Anyone? So we have...
Can you repeat the questions, please?
Yeah, do you have a bank account? And if so, why? Shireen, can you see the screen? Because the questions are on the screen.
Well, I can hear, I can see the screen.
Yeah, okay, Tasub can see the screen. Shireen, can you see the screen?
No, your voice is not clear.
My voice is not clear, okay, how about now? Okay,
I can hear you now.
Okay, yeah, just take a look at your phone or whatever you're using. On the screen, you'll see the presentation. And in the presentation are all the questions I'm asking now.
I couldn't find it. One second, please.
Okay, I'll let Tasub speak and then until you figure it out, okay?
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I have a bank account. To be honest, I work in freelancing marketplace like Upwork and Fiverr. So
you work in what? Sorry.
in outsourcing marketplace. Do you know about something Upwork or something called Fiverr?
Called what? Sorry, I can't hear you well.
I may not be able to describe all the thing right now. I think
okay. But you're specialized in what field?
Well, I am a specialist in doing SEO. Do you know what is SEO is?
SEO?
SEO, search engine optimization.
You are actually overqualified for this class, Tasub. You have a lot of information, which I'm really glad that you are here with us today. So tell me, what is it? Enlighten me.
Okay, it's like suppose you are doing a PowerPoint presentation today, right?
Yeah.
You want to share this PowerPoint presentation all over the internet, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Suppose you try to sell this presentation, okay?
Mm.
Okay, how you can do that? If you want to sell this, you need a way. That way is called SEO or search engine optimization, so that search engine can understand that this madam want to sell or this sir want to sell this product. Okay. And they have some criteria, and within this criteria or within this category, you have to post your PowerPoint presentation so that they can understand this is a thing which I need to sell. Okay. And the search engine will send to those who want to buy this presentation. Okay.
So is it some kind of marketing, or you're more dealing with like IT things?
It's an IT technique, to be honest. Okay. It's not a marketing field. You can say both, to be honest, but it's an IT skill. If you have the IT skill, you don't need to focus on marketing a lot. If you have content, a good content, that is the best marketing you can do. Okay, the question is, do you have a bank account? And if so, why? Okay. Well, bank account to be honest, I'm doing my post graduation also.
Okay.
So for my case, as I work in marketplace, I had to maintain a MasterCard. Do you know anything about a Pioneer MasterCard?
I know MasterCard, yes.
Sorry?
Yes. I know about MasterCard, just the normal cards. If you have more advanced thing, I don't think I know about it. I know that's just the normal MasterCards.
Yeah, it's normal MasterCard. Yeah. You can transact money from anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
So that's thing is needed if you work on online or any other MasterCard. That's why I use sometimes that, and other time I use Bitcoin, and Bitcoin don't require a bank, to be honest. That's a different question. So that's my answer to your question. As you have other participants, I think you should share them.
Yeah, them thank you very much, Tasub. Thanks. Farah, we'll have Farah. Farah, unmute yourself.
So I think obviously I don't have a bank account.
Okay.
I might assume why people have bank accounts. Obviously I'm 14 years old, so I don't have a bank account.
Yeah.
But I can assume why people do have bank accounts.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, go ahead. Tell me why.
It varies, which is kind of amazing for me to know that some people, even people with sort of low budget money, I'm not trying to be rude or anything, but some people with low budget money even have the bank accounts because they work national jobs. That's what it's called.
Mm-hmm.
So the way they take their money is they take in their money using the banks, but also other people who have like a lot of money, they can't keep much money at home because of course robbery happens, and at home it's more obviously it's less secure than in a bank.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
And if it's in a bank, the bank is supposed to give you back the money if it's robbed.
Yeah.
Like if somebody robbed the bank and your money was taken, somebody has to go, the bank has to give you back its money.
Yeah.
So this is why people might have
insurance.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm.
And also, some people must have bank accounts for starting a business.
Yeah. Definitely. Yeah,
that's all I know.
That's perfect. And I like this part that, yeah, actually not all people get have a bank account, especially if they work like nationally or something. So yes, but if they do, it's actually for their salaries and stuff and for business. So yeah, that's basically it. Thank you, Farah.
Thank you.
Okay, good. So one thing. Well, does anyone would like to say anything about that? Like Shireen. Yes, Shireen, sorry.
Yeah.
I forgot about you. So you have a bank account.
Yeah, I think Shireen, it's important. Right? Yeah, I think it's important to everyone to have a bank account.
Okay, go ahead. And why?
Because it's something safe to your life.
Okay.
Like a pandemic right now, everyone. Most of people are out of work right now.
Mm.
And if they work to have a money in their bank account, they will feel better now.
Okay.
They can earn, they can get the benefit from their money return.
Mm.
It will make him feel, you know, what I can say.
Yes, if they get money so they can.
Put my in.
Okay.
Yeah. In our family, from time to time, bank account for us, it's very, very, very important.
Okay.
Yeah. If you get money from your work, from anything, but bank account is still the important point. You have to work on it.
Yeah.
And I think, what do you think?
I think so. It's for different people, it's different reasons. But as you said, like if some people would earn actually some money while they are just staying home, they know the benefits comes out from their account. For me personally, like I have a bank account, but for me it's all about, you know, using my card and the shopping and everything, and the online banking. I love the online banking, you know, like being able to do everything on
and
my
I
phone.
Love you. How much? But I know another people earn a lot of money and they don't think to have a bank account, so they waste their money without doing anything. Yeah, I know someone can earn a lot of money, but in the same time, he don't have money. He get the money,
and they spend it straight away.
Oh no, where the money disappear?
Yeah,
but
I know.
It affect on her, on his family.
Hmm.
From time to time, they ask, where you waste your money? He have a bad reason. Yeah, you can't converse with the reason, and you don't have a word to tell him that you have to stop.
Yeah.
For doing that.
Okay, so, you know what, Shireen? I know that you're absolutely right, and I believe that all of us, you know, we just buy things that we don't need. We think that we need, but we don't need, because we can actually live without these things.
There is something called responsibility. He don't live alone. He's sharing his life with some people. He should think well, because they count on him. So he's one of my friends, really, but I couldn't. That's why I have to do that.
Yeah, I totally understand what you're saying. And this
way, I can ask how much. I can ask how much. And but I'm thinking before to buy anything. Yeah, I want to ask how much, but I think before to take the decision.
But as we always say, you know, it's a double weapon, you know, like you can this is the pros and cons of everything. Like you can have even a very peaceful thing in your hand, and I can use it wisely, and you can use it like in a crazy way or in a bad way. That so yeah. So well, for when they create,
I have to think more before I waste my one. I love to think more.
Oh, that's good, Shireen. You're so wise.
not thinking. Think in right way. If I wanted that right now, or I can delay for another time.
Yeah, that's right. What
pandemic should learn us that point.
Yeah, it told us. Yes.
It helped. Yes, it's a good point from the pandemic. It's a good point. We have to focus on that point. We have to think more before we get anything, because we don't know what's gonna happen.
Yes, you're right. Sorry.
Right.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Thank you so much, Shireen. Let me see who else didn't speak today. We have, I'm not sure if Boda Hain. I'm not sure. Am I pronouncing it right? So if you can hear me, would you please speak up? Hello? Okay, then we'll have Hanan. Would you like to share with us your idea? Hello?
Hello, hi.
Hello, Buhani. Am I pronouncing your name
correct? Budahan.
Oh, sorry, Budahan. I'm sorry. Yeah. Where are you from?
From Tunisia, but I live in Ireland.
Hello. Okay.
Hello.
So you're a mate now. You live in Ireland. That's good. So maybe one day we will meet.
I am Duha when I write.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Doha. Okay. Okay, Doha. So thanks for joining us today. Would you like to participate with us, or would you rather listen?
The both.
Okay. So what do you see on the screen?
What is the question?
Can you see the screen?
What is the...
No, the screen.
Yours.
Yeah.
You. I see you.
Okay, and can you see the picture of the ATM? Okay, so I will speak slowly, okay? So do you use ATM? Do you use it?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So do you have a bank account?
Yes.
Yeah. Good.
And yes.
Yeah. And you have a card, right? Card.
Card.
Good. And you use your card while shopping?
Yeah. In shopping.
Yeah. Great.
To buy
something. Yes. Okay, very good. So use your card to buy something. Okay, good. So when you go to the supermarkets, you use your card, and when you go to shop for clothes or something?
Yes. When I go in shop, I use the card.
Good. Very good. Doha, thank you for your participation.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Hopefully I can see you maybe somewhere. Do you live in Dublin?
Yes, I live in Balbriggan.
Balbriggan, okay. If I
near.
You are in a lockdown now. I'm in Wexford. I can't meet you.
Where are you are live here?
Wexford.
Oh, okay. Next day.
Yeah.
Maybe one day.
And say, is that your husband?
Tell him
thank you. You can even join us if you want.
I'm here. I'm listening.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Doha, she's new here in Ireland.
Okay, yeah.
She would like to learn more English with you. So help her, please.
Yeah, of course. I'm really happy that she's joining today, and she's brave and she's trying. So that's perfect.
She speaks more than that. She's a bit shy now.
I see. Yeah, I feel that.
Yes. She's attending the school every morning now in here in Balbriggan.
Okay.
And she's doing well. Yeah.
Yeah, I can say that, and hopefully maybe one day after the lockdown we can see each other.
Oh, it would be nice. Would be nice. Yeah, would be nice. Yeah.
Thanks.
Thanks for what you're doing for the people, and nice to meet you. And keep do what you're doing. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yes. Thanks. Bye.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you, Daha. Okay, Hanan. Sorry. You can go ahead now.
Hello. Hanan, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you well.
According or to the point of if we have a bank account, I think most of the people these days, especially after the pandemic, they started having these account banking. You know, most of the companies now are doing the work online and selling and doing most of the work. Most of the people are working from home. Yeah. And I think this transaction of money will be very easy through the banking accounts, more than receiving the money by the person who is as an accountant and going to the bank, putting the money there and then, or withdrawing whatever is going to happen personally or manually or done by a person. Now I think during or through the accounts it will be within a second.
Yes,
will happen.
Yeah, of course. And,
I think also having a bank account is not for only for people who are working, but also for students, those who are studying abroad. Personally, for myself, my son is studying abroad, and I'm this is a big chance, a good, a very good chance to me to transfer money for him. And this is as a studying fees or as a family support also. So maybe those who are under age only, who doesn't, who do not have the bank account, or those who are not working, for example, or. So it's very, very important these days to have this account. And for women, this is very, very important.
It is. Yes.
You know, how can we shop without going outside or without leaving houses? How can we shop? How can we order for food? How can we do a huge transaction process happens during this pandemic, especially during the lockdown that we had.
Yeah, it's very important. And I always like, how can we do our couch shopping? So we're sitting on the sofa and we are doing our shopping. It's very important. And
you feel very happy. You feel very happy once the doorbell is ringing, then you get your your order there.
Yes, you're absolutely right. So tell me, Hanan, do you know what is the abbreviation of ATM?
It's an automatic teller machine, I think.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Perfect. And thank you so much for you and for the partner. His name is Tasup, I think. Yes, he gave us a very good information about banking. Really, really.
Maybe we can ask him to be a guest or something in one of our meetings, and he can talk. He has a lot actually to say,
especially about Bitcoin.
Yeah, that's would you like to ask him a question or something, Hanan?
All what you have said before that about Bitcoin, and there was a very important point that he discussed also about the joint account. I think it was new for me. I didn't know. Is he ready to help others for as for free, I mean, to help people who are in need to start their work online or some projects that they have. If he's willing to do this, this will be great for people. Others are needing, they need this. I think many are in need for this.
Okay, I won't ask him this question live, but he sent his email here. And I can send him an email and ask him if he if he's interested to do that. Actually, we have a lot. Hanan, just one last question for you before you go. Do you know the types of bank accounts?
Types?
Yeah, I mean, like when you go and
Actually, I'm not working or I'm not doing too many visits to the bank to know many accounts. Oh, my husband did mine. That's why I don't have an idea. If please, I'm waiting. I'm listening to others to know the
information. Okay, I will say it quickly because I want to give you 5 minutes, guys. If you want, if someone would like to ask a question, so we have two. There are like for the personal bank accounts, there are two types of accounts. So you can have a current account or a saving account. So the current account, I think the most of the manual users have this kind of account just to check your balance and use the card and do your shopping and stuff like that. But the saving account is the one that you put like some money in that money and you don't touch them, so you can have interest or, you know, you can actually benefit from that money when you leave it for a certain time. So it's the difference between them. I just wanted to make sure. So there are actually a lot of vocabulary about banking. Yes. And I'm like, I don't, well, 1 hour is certainly not enough.
But we really got so many information, really. Thank you so much.
Thanks very much, Hanan, for being with us today. And unfortunately, the hour is finished. So if anybody would like to ask a question, go ahead, just 5 minutes before we go. And one last thing, Shireen, would you like to say something?
Yes. Yeah. I want you to tell me.
Just 1 minute, Shireen, okay? English. Oh, okay. Go ahead. Sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, I want you to tell me how you find my English and how you find my English. It's good or need to more practice or what?
We all need more practice. I need more practice. Everybody needs more practice, okay? But the thing is,
you get my point.
Yeah, I get your point.
You get my point.
Yeah, you speak very well. Okay, I think you speak very well. You just, if you are stuck with words, you want to, you know, say things fast. So just, you know, relax and try to, you know, think and just say, nobody's here is gonna, you know, push you to speak fast or something. But you are doing great, Shireen. Just keep up the hard work. I think
you
are doing great.
Thank you. Thank you. Give me a positive words. That will make me talk more.
You should know that yourself. You are so good. So
I'm so happy to talking to you today.
I'm really happy to have you in the class today. It's my pleasure. Thank you so much, Shireen. Farah asked the question. You. Yeah, go ahead, Farah.
So it's actually something about English, a bit more about reading.
Okay. Yeah, can you repeat your question?
I didn't ask it yet. I'm reading. I started reading the novel Gulliver's Travels this year in my school curriculum.
Okay.
And we're supposed to be independent in reading it, which means we have to read it at home alone.
Yeah.
Answer questions about it. So my problem is actually that the reading itself. There are some words that are kind of hard. And sometimes when I keep on reading and reading and reading, I sort of feel like I'm reading words, but nothing is coming inside my mind. I feel like I'm not reading anything at all.
Okay. You know, Farah, this happens even if you are reading something in your mother language, okay? And especially because in your mind, I'm reading something more for school. So this makes us even feel more bored to do the thing, okay? But I always say, first, physically, don't sit on, uncomfortable chair. Don't sit on the bed while reading, your book, because you are sitting in a possession of sleeping more than, actually reading. Try to sit maybe on a desk or something. Do something before you start reading. Do something first that you like. Okay, so let's say you like, let's stay away from Facebook and stuff. Let's say that you like some kind of music, or you like to listen to Quran or something. So do that before you start your reading, so you feel like you are not doing all about the studying only. Okay, and then after you actually start reading, when you feel that your mind starts wandering, stop and then go for like maybe 1 minute, just walk or drink water or do something and then come back. Okay, because it will be like pointless thinking that you are reading and reading and reading and you're actually doing something when your mind wander, your mind is actually in somewhere else. So try this, and actually I'll Google this for you. And maybe we can talk about it next. You Google it, I'll Google it. And then if you will be here in the class next week, at the end of the class, we can talk about it. What did we find online? What do you think? Now, where are you, Farah?
I'm here. Yeah. Thank you. That would be so great. But I just wanted to point to something. I do like reading, but the problem is, as you say, my mind kind of wanders. That's the only problem.
Yeah, just I do something kind of else, like and reading. I don't come read back. It's important, believe me, Farah. It's very important to do okay. something else. Take a break. And don't do the whole thing, like don't spend like few hours doing the reading, maybe half an hour, and then treat yourself. And I mean like really treat yourself. If you like to drink hot chocolate, if you like, you may maybe call a friend for 5 minutes or something, this is refresh your mind. So when you come back, it's different. And it's also when you are saying, well, okay, I'm gonna have my treat after half an hour, you will work hard to get your treat, okay? So do that and try. Let's see if it's going to work. Okay, Farah?
Okay, thank you so much for the advice.
You're so welcome.
Thank you so much.
Oh, sorry. I muted you by mistake. Okay, guys.
No, it's fine. It's okay.
Okay, thanks, Farah. So, guys, unfortunately, the hour is finished. Just one last thing about this picture on the screen. When you, well, this is actually called, I don't have time to explain it now. This is called a currency exchange, okay? When you have, for example, dollars and you want to get euros. So this, you know, exchanging currency or currency exchange, okay? It's important word to know since we are talking about money and banking. So anybody else has any question before we finish? And feel free to unmute yourself. So we only have 5 people left. So we have Hanan, Farah, Shireen, Tasub. Anybody would like to say anything before we finish?
Thank you for this session, and this is a very informative session. And about exchanging money, that there are some people or there are some organization or agency, those who are you know, collect some money and give you some money. There are some difference between some currency, and it's up down every single minute. It's like share market.
Yeah,
it's something like that. And if you exchange money and that money is no or something more, you get some interest too. So yeah. That's one kind of business also.
Yeah.
So that's I think need to mention. So I think you you know, arrange this whole class in a very categorized way, and I think you are so organized.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Tasub. Well, I'm really happy to hear that from you. So thanks very much. And thanks for joining us. And hopefully I will see you again next week.
I hope. I think the timetable will not be really suitable for me. I think if I can contact with you any other way, we can select some time if it is possible. That would be good. But thank you for
today's session. Okay, I can't hear you, Tasub, but thanks so much for your participation. Thank you all for being here today, and I will see you at the same time next week, inshallah. Thank you so very much. Assalamu alaikum.